Alright, we're back with Pokémon Sun. Here's a trainer. I did go and heal and buy some potions and revives and all that stuff. But another thing I did was change up most moveset a bit. Because, well, those that watched the previous video, or at least read the description, I guess, might be aware that the Sparkling Area C-move, Opera, whatever, kind of forgot the name there, that actually supposedly, at least sometimes, triggers the copyright censors of Pokemon Japan for some reason. It's apparently only that one and not even the other starter ones, which is weird. But I had to re-upload the video and there's just black space over those. Now, obviously, that's not exactly interesting to watch, so I removed both Sparkling Area and the Sea Stone from Mo. And I can't even put the Water Sea move on her because Amelia already has that. But I'll probably stick the Sea Fairy Rock on it eventually. So I'll probably switch because Riflim is a bit of an issue here. Sanlavania is risky. But yeah, so that's unfortunate, but what can you do? I did see that someone had made an animation to replace it and it was kind of funny, but I don't think I have the abilities to make animation like that out of nowhere. Probably could have done something with it, but I just mostly want the video back up, so yeah. But that aside, I missed this trainer last time because I was trying really hard to talk to this person, but I accidentally activated the cutscene, and that doesn't seem like something you should want to do with Vibrava against a literal thing made out of sand. I'm pretty sure that increases my special defense, actually. Maybe it's just rock types. Vibrava kind of sucks, anyways. I mean, it starts out as Trapinch, which is slower than Sin but hits ridiculously hard. Then it evolves into Vibrava and it loses that attack and it gains kind of mediocre stats instead. And honestly, sure, it now has speed, but that's really all it has going for it, so I almost feel like Trapinch is actually the better option. I did not mean to go to the entrance, thank you very much. But yeah, then it evolves into Flygon and it has pretty decent stats. And I guess it has the status of being a Pokemon that a lot of people want to have to get an Mega Evolution, but like, right. What? I'm a bit confused. Wasn't this lab 2? You were supposed to be in lab 1, right? Hold on, then what was in the other direction? I assumed that was lab 1 and like lab 2 is this way. No, apparently these are just fake doors. Well, okay, they're not fake doors, they're just not open. Okay. Oh, cube. Let's see. Mm-hmm, there's signs of life here. But how did you really have to rush in? I could have snaked my way through without them ever noticing me. Mm-hmm. Is how going to help me? Vanillish. I like vanillish. Okay, let's see here. That ice cream is certainly going to be a problem. That Machoke is no longer a problem, apparently. Okay. I was going to solve the problem with whatever, but okay. That did more than I was expecting. That's probably going to do more than I'd like. Okay. Nah, Christina lived just fine. Well, okay. That was simple enough. Yeah, that was not super difficult. Okay. No. No, I didn't. Oh? So, does that mean that Gladion is going to lose miserably? Because they're supposedly better at fighting. Okay, that's a fake door. Wow, that's not an obvious book. Wait, that book wasn't it? Uh-huh. I see. Okay. That's actually not what I had in mind. So, what about this book, though? Nothing particularly interesting, I guess. Reminds me of the log entries in the Prime games, because I haven't talked about those enough yet. Mm-hmm. Yeah, so then we go up, I guess. Are we stuck down here now? Nah. I guess I probably should be finding things. Is there any signs of life here? There is another book. What do you mean deleted files? They're not very deleted if I can just see them. Mm-hmm. Oh? That could be interesting. Type change program. Oh. Oh, here we go. The Arceus system. I'm going to call it Arceus system just because why not? Okay, whatever. So that means they're talking about type null then. Okay, so type full. There's a lot of files here. Okay. But wait. That's I mean, I pretty much know where this is going. But I don't know. I know where that information is going. Oh, hi, a Pokeball. But I'm not sure if it's going to be addressed further in the game itself. Did Hau heal me? Yeah, okay. Because I already know there's supposed to be 3 type nulls around, I guess, so yeah. So I assume I head back to the entrance now. Yeah. Yeah, please. Yeah, that's pretty much the standard solution. And there's a bunch of people. I see, so does everyone on Eater Paradise know what this secret is, or is it just a limited amount of people? Because that pretty much cements all of you as villains, so okay, so more playing around with Hau. Okay, that's fair enough. Marsdale should be taking some decent damage. I assumed that was going to happen, so I wasn't too worried about any kind of wing attacks coming at Christina. Not quite as much as I was hoping. Oh, right, it does that. And right, she couldn't even leave that with my help. Leafeon. Well, that makes this fight very easy. And that's a special move, so stamina didn't even come to play there. I would have preferred to fight with Gladion here instead. Captivate? What did that do again? Nah, I'll pass. Yeah. I'm not sure if we're actually aiming to be champions though. Wasn't that supposed to be like half secret? So how about we have some real people match us? Glad. I remember the good old days of using. Aren't you glad, Ian? As a pun. Okay, yeah, okay. Good. Actually, let's not talk about bad puns. Because the last one was also a bad pun. She's talking about you, Hau. Or me. Definitely. I don't think my team particularly needed healing. Yeah. really nice person. Yeah, I'm sure. Can we fight you to open the doors? No? Okay. So, Wicke, are you going to stand around here as a healer? Because that would be pretty nice. Oh boy! A pile of grunts and a faba. Are you going to fight me again? I see. If you have the key, and you're the only one that has the key, maybe you should just... Yeah, what Hao said. Wow, okay. Alright, so I guess we do get to fight with Gladion as our helper here. Worthless grunts, of course. Well, maybe the third grunt will fight Hao, and after that we have a double battle against Faba and how did I forget her name? I said it like a split second ago. What the hell happened here? Okay, so I'm going to actually just U-turn out of this, because this matchup is not looking exactly great. Also, this frame rate is not looking all that great either. And seriously, both got paralyzed? Wow. Okay, please don't let the confusion or the paralysis come into play. And just U-turn out. The magma is almost dead though. Maybe I'll U-turn it instead. Christina can take one super effective fire move, right? I mean, oh right, discharge. Wow. That is so dumb. Okay, well, that's not gonna be enough. Well, for once I have a good reason to throw Sandalvania in. So far, Electabuzz has done nothing but use Discharge, so I'm thinking this might be a decent matchup for once. Let's just bulldoze everything. Yeah, I don't particularly care about type null here. Yeah, I'm pretty sure that was more than enough. Simple enough. Also, I am kind of taking note of the fact that it seems my team is slightly starting to be underleveled. And that's totally fine by me. Oh, are we going to have a double battle with Faba and a Grunt? Okay, no. Oh, so we go back to using Hao as a friend dog? Okay, whatever, we'll roll with it. I'm glad we got to have more Faba in this segment though. Still just... No, he has a full team. Well, full and full since this is still a double battle, so it's not like he can have more than three. Also, her name was Wicca. I just remembered. That's how bad my memory is. Because it kind of isn't. So I assume something is going to kick the bucket before I even get to do something. And I was hoping that would actually take Ledian out immediately. Because that's kind of a problem. It's nice to see that Ledian is used as a support support role instead of trying to pretend it can actually fight on its own. Because it kind of can't. And with that in mind, I think Christina is kind of a bad matchup here now. Why didn't you just Electro Ball it? Electro Ball isn't physical, right? I don't think it is. Well, whatever. Switching to something that does good special damage to Slowbro, so Barry it is. Alright, Bugbuzz is going to take it out and... Alright, Raichu fell asleep. No. Can we not? Can we not do that? Okay, I didn't like that one at all. That's what I get for... saying Ledian is worthless, I guess. Alright, let's just... sing zap Slowbro here. Huh, look, Raichu woke up. And for some reason used Quick Attack. I mean, it was faster than Ledian anyway, so... Electric Terran? That could be interesting, but doesn't really work with just one electric type Pokemon here. Christina is now 38, that's pretty good actually. Probably should switch her out of the front as soon as I can. Okay, well, I don't like where this is going because I'd rather not Pikachu fall asleep, so let me actually switch again. Replaced a Sparkling Aria with Psychic, because I didn't really have anything else that would be decent. Why are you... What are these moves you're using? You should be just... electro-balling them. I wonder if Faba, being a Psychic-type user, has a C-move ready. Because in that case, I might get my Psychic C-stone from this fight. Oh, Hypno is back. Well, Mo is not the worst matchup for this thing. This Raichu could stop using dumb moves, though. Not a fan of that one. Do I want to switch out to something else here? Sanylvania has super effective moves at least. Maybe it'll try to use Nightmare or something dumb that probably shouldn't be used ever. No, it tried to diagnose the Raichu as well. That's fine by me. Let's just never-ending nightmare it then. Anything to get some decent victories under Sanylvania's belt. I mean, I remember that last time Sanylvania won because it got lucky with Hypnosis missing constantly, so... This time, that happened again, kind of, but this time Raichu was the one avoiding it, so... Yeah. Oh, Mokura level up too. Praxis? Yeah. Okay, this thing... It's going to have Crunch, isn't it? Okay, back to Pimachu. Definitely. it's because I'm almost certain it's going to have some kind of a... Oh. Oh, I wasn't even thinking about that. That's pretty excellent. So that's why Raichu didn't use it while Pimachu was in, but that doesn't really explain anything else about it. But now Pimachu is going to just blow through this Bruxish in one hit pretty much. Yeah, that was a lot of damage. Oh, it actually lived. Well, that's not really a big deal because it doesn't leave that one. Okay, that went surprisingly okay. And the grunt is gone. Are you going to give the key? Like for reals? Because there's no reason for you to actually do that, you know. There really is no reason for you to be doing that. Mm-hmm. Did I get healed there? Yes, I did. Let's switch to a melee here. I don't see her being super useful though. Don't have anything of value to say. Okay, there's a bunch of team Grunt skulls here. And Guzma, I guess. Yugu Billion. Oh, okay, we'll go with that. Do I have to? It kind of looks like I have to. I'm the main character. Can I avoid everything by running this way? Jeez, this is a large area. Have I been here before? Full heal, yeah. Can I find something that's more useful? This one is out cold, and so is that one. Is there a good DM lurking around the corner? I would like that. I assume there's a cube. I wasn't assuming there to be a cube. I was assuming there to be something, which I guess a cube is something, but... Okay, so I guess we're doing the whole thing again. Nugget Bridge kind of thing. Just a gauntlet of stuff. Starting out with Golbat, it seems. Yeah, not exactly the best matchup for a melee here. Well, it's not a bad one. It's just not good. Now I don't even have the option of not dealing with this with a melee. But Skull should be more than enough. That did a lot less damage than I was hoping. More Skull in and we'll see where that leads. Ah, there's the burn. Swift is a physical move, right? Because I'm not totally sure about that. I guess we'll see. No, I don't think it is. It used to be before the physical special split, but yeah. Well, I might as well heal up. No harm in doing that, really. That burn is not going to take it out yet, so I'll throw a sludge bomb in. Hmm. Okay, that was enough to deal with that. Yeah, you got crushed. Alright. Next! So I assume Clarion and Guzma are having a fight right now, probably. I assume Guzma is going to win. Raticate? Yeah, I can handle a Raticate. But yeah, a melee skull did not do much to that Golbat, so would hopefully be about time for melee to evolve. Not in this fight unless I have to switch her out here. That was a dark type move, so Barry should resist that and then KO back, right? Oh. Not sure why Asurans instead of Crunch, but yeah, whatever. And then just Bug Pass. That should be enough. Yeah, quite easily in fact. Okay. You don't have money. I'd rather not heal, so let me switch Barry to the front here. And deal with the last trainer. I assume I'm getting... I'm assuming I'm getting healed. Yeah, it seems like he handily lost. Oh. Am I going to have to beat you now? Okay. So I guess it's time for third fight with Guzma. Great. I don't have any other problem with this, but he actually has 4 Pokemon now, but I didn't get to heal before this, so this could get hairy very quickly. But yeah, he sort of started out with the best, so let's throw some stun spore at it. Oh, I was assuming he was going to immediately switch out, but I forgot it has an ability that does it for it. I don't think I have any other options here, other than Pimachu. Who's going to do a decent job, really. I assume that's going to do half. No? Well, in that case... oops, not what I'm meant to do. Let's just remove Collie Support without it getting to do any switching shenanigans. That seems like a reasonable thing to do. I mean, again, this is taking a while. Now that should be more than enough. I mean, things that did almost half to begin with, so yeah. Okay, his ace is out, that leaves me with 2 new Pokemon to worry about. Pinsir. Okay. As long as it doesn't Mega Evolve, I don't particularly care. Oh, it's faster. Yeah, that hurts. I was hoping to paralyze it first. Okay, my team is not well equipped to deal with bugs, huh? Well, it can't use Prick Break against Sandalvania, so that's a plus, if nothing else. Yeah, let's just roll with Shadow Ball here. Oh, that's a resisted hit, so I assume it doesn't have anything better in its sleeve. So that's not going to actually help me in the long run. Yeah, this fight is going to be a tough one. I'm thinking Sandalvania is just going to have to take this hit here. Okay, let me think. Christina is not an option. Mo resists Prick Break at least. And Scald should be probably hopefully enough. Oh, and it does resist that. No, it doesn't. Does it? No, it doesn't. Okay. Whatever. Two down, two to go. Masquerain. Okay, Masquerain has never been a huge threat, but it did get a huge stat boost in this generation, so this thing is not complete garbage anymore. I mean, I wouldn't say it ever was, because this thing is actually pretty good for what it's worth. I used one in Omega Ruby, and it was probably one of my better members, honestly. Then again, it's a team that used Love Disc, so I don't think its quality was ever in question. I'm going to do something that might end up biting me in the ass. I'm going to immediately switch Amelie out just so I can get that healing. If it uses Air Slash, Christina probably dies immediately. Yeah. Barely took that hit. But I don't think she's fast enough to actually do anything about it. Yeah. But at any rate, Masquerain is definitely a great one now. I mean, it, competitively speaking, it probably isn't all that much better. But casually speaking, it has a lot higher offenses now than before, so it can break stuff. How well can you take that? You can't. Well, shit. I actually lost. Should have healed before that. I wasn't exactly expecting having to fight Guzma again, actually. That's unfortunate. Well, now I'm going to be more than well enough prepared for that fight. I do like how Gladion has the ability to just be here as well. Okay. This is going to take a while to get back, but well. Not totally sure what would be the best course of action here. Think I might want to start out with Pimachu, since if nothing else, that can at least two-shot the thing. I assume if I start with Nuzzle, the second strong hit is... Actually, I don't really want to use my Z-move that early. It could have been very useful later on. So, let's give this another shot. I might want to start off with Nuzzle and then do Zing Zaps. That's probably going to mean it's going to switch out, but I'm not super worried about Paralyzed Golisopod, to be completely honest here. Then again, it might just flat out be faster than Pimachu and one-shot it anyways. No? Not. That's good. That was a crit. Okay, so it should switch out as soon as I Zing Zap it. Yeah. It'll be back, but that's not a huge problem. Now, I know better with this abomination. So I know immediately to switch into Sandalvania to avoid Brick Break. Yeah. And, well, not like it's going to do huge amounts of damage here, but it'll do something at least. Oh! That changes things. I'm going to nuke this thing right off the bat, if I can. Ah, what a shame. Sandalvania couldn't take the hit. That's fine though. Barry has no super effective moves against it. So that's not a good option. Well, nothing really has super effective moves. Actually, Barry might be decent. I can probably two-shot this thing. If not just flat-out KO it, at least I'll be faster, so... Ah, that wasn't quite enough. But, well, Barry is faster than pretty much anything he can throw out, so... That's not a huge issue. Actually, the Masquerain is probably the fastest on the team, and I don't think Masquerain is that fast. That Intimidate is unfortunate, because it doesn't come into play at all. Let's stun it, because I'd rather have the other members of this team be actually able to outspeed it. Barry is just going to have to take this one again. Now, it's a flying bug type, so having Pimachu alive actually makes it very easy. I don't think it has anything it can really do. Ah, it lived? Really? Well, not a huge deal. Pretty much anything will KO it now. Let's go with Poison Jab, I guess. Yeah, that worked out fine. Okay, and Golisopod is back. I don't really care. Pimachu is going to immediately wipe it out. So, have fun with that, I guess. So, the last Pokémon is... What exactly? Oh, right. The Ariados. Okay, well, let's start with Nuzzle. Yeah. Not a fan of that. I'm not going to switch out with Pimachu so someone else can get the EXP if this goes south, and it went south very fast. That's fine. I assume I'm going to get very much healed after this one, so... Melee can probably handle it. It's already paralyzed, so I can't get a burn on it, so I might as well Hydro Vortex. That does a lot of damage. Though if Sucker Punch is pretty much your only move to go with, that means some melee can just recover you to death pretty much. But yeah. That was not enough. Well, I assume it's not like he's going to be using healing items or anything, so... I like how I completely forgot that I should probably not do that. Okay, well, Mo gets to wrap it up then, I guess. Alright, Mo had a super effective move against it. I kind of forgot. But at any rate, that should be it. Another level up for Mo. Hyper Voice? Yeah, I'll take Hyper Voice. Disarming Voice is too weak to actually be relevant, really. So, I'll take Hyper Voice for a bit. It's probably not going to be useful. It would be useful if I had Primarina's hidden ability, which makes all voice moves into water moves, but there's probably better options than water type hyper voice. Yeah. Oh, I get to go through. No healing. Yeah, I think we're gonna call it quits here, and next time, well, next time we finish probably Eater Paradise, and we'll see where that leads. Yeah, bye.